Всеволод Жанович Сагбаев with the talk representations of groups in infinite dimensional hyperspace equipped with an invariant measure. Please, you have 50 minutes plus 10 minutes for questions, please.
Thank you, Alexander Evgenievich. Firstly, I want to thank the organizers for the creation of this beautiful conference and for the opportunity to present the talk under the following title, Representation of Group in Infinite Dimensional Hyperspace Space Equipped with an Invariant Measure. The plan of this report is the following. Firstly, we studied the general problem of invariantness of measures with respect to topological groups without the locally compactness property. As the second step, we study measures on real separable Hilbert space that are invariant with respect to group of fifths and with respect to group of orthogonal mappings. After that, we consider the averaging of random walks in Hilbert space and study the properties of diffusion, the heat semigroup and its generator. And after that, we investigate the symplectic invariant measures on Hilbert space equipped with fifth invariant symplectic form. And as a final step, we want to consider the Koopman unitary representation of groups of nonlinear Hamiltonian flows and the properties of this unitary Koopman groups. According to Andrei Weil's theorem, if a topological group is not locally compact, then there is no non-trivial sigma additive, sigma finite, locally finite Borel measure on the group G, which is left invariant with respect to action of any elements of this group. If we consider the Nord linear space as the topological group with the summation operation, then we obtain that there is no Lebesgue measure on an infinite dimensional Nord linear space. There is no measure with all these properties. Therefore, if we want to equip the Nord linear space with the measure which is invariant with respect to shift, then we should restrict one or more than one properties which is listed in this theorem. And there is a different approach to construct the analog of Lebesgue measure on an infinite dimensional topological vector space. For example, in the works by Baker, Hrzyashvili, Zawadzki, the property of sigma finiteness of considered shift invariant measure is restricted, and these authors construct countable additive shift invariant measures on a locally convex space of sequences. Another approach to this topic is created by professors Smolyanov and Professor Shamarov. They construct the generalized measure on a Hilbert space as the linear functional on the proper space of test functions. And this generalized measure has the property of shift invariantness and invariantness with respect to rotations of this Hilbert space. And in the group which include me and my colleagues Vladimir Busovikov and Vladimir Glazatov, the shift invariant measure is studied as the finitely additive shift invariant and rotation invariant measure, and we restrict the property of countable additivity of the measure. Now I want to note that the Lebesgue measure on the finite dimension of Euclidean space is invariant to orthogonal group, and it is invariant to the group of shifts along the free divergence smooth vector fields. And now we want to investigate the following questions. Does the considered analog of Lebesgue measure on the infinite dimensional Hilbert space admit the following type of invariantness as in finite dimensional Euclidean space? To construct the shift invariant measure on a real separable Hilbert space, we should introduce the collection of elementary sets. We should define the additive function on this collection of elementary sets. And after that, we should extend this additive function up to the measure on the ring, which is generated by this collection of elementary sets. We can see the following definition of elementary sets, which is used in works by in books by Skorohod, by Shilov, and other literature. A set pi in the space E is called rectangle if there are orthonormal bases E sub G or A calligraph, and there is the vectors A and B from the space L infinity such that the set P consists of all vectors from the space E, which coordinates with respect to this orthonormal basis, satisfies the following countable collection of conditions. A rectangle one is called measurable if it is either empty set or the following condition on the lenses of this interval satisfies. If pi is empty set, then we define the function. We define that the function lambda on the empty set is equal to zero. And if pi is non-empty rectangle, then we define the function lambda on the measurable rectangle as the product of the length of edges of these rectangles. And according to the condition two, this product converges converges and is not depends on the ordering of these edges. Sorry. Now we construct the measure, which is the extension of this function of a set. For any orthonormal basis E, the symbol K1 of E knows the set of measurable rectangles which edge scalinear to the vectors of orthonormal basis E. And let a small sub E be a ring generated by the class of sets K1 of E. The definition of the measure is the following: a function M which is defined on the collection of set R with values in real line is called a measure on the space E if R is a ring of subsets of the space E and the function M is additive. Lemma 1 states the following: let E be an orthonormal basis in the space E, then the function of a set 3, which is defined on the collection of measurable rectangles with edge scalinear to the orthonormal basis E, this function is additive on this collection of a set. Moreover, this function of a set has the unique additive extension to the ring R small, which is generated by this collection of a set. This extension is a finite additive measure on the space E. And what is the properties of this measure? Let E be an orthonormal basis in the space E, then we can define the outer and interior measure of an arbitrary set A from the space E by the usual way. As the outer measure is defined by the following way by means of all covering of the set A by the set from the ring R small, and analogously definition of the interior measure. Let us note by by R capital sub E the collection of sets such that the interior and outer measures of the set coincides at finite. For example, let us consider the interior and outer measure of balls in Euclidean space. Let B sub R be a ball in the space E of radius R. If R smaller than the following number, then this ball is measurable and the measure of small ball is equal to zero. If the radius of ball greater than this number, then the external, the outer measure of this ball is equal to infinity and interior measure of this ball is equal to zero. Thus, not open set, that this measure has no extension on the Borel sigma algebra. And theorem 1 describes the properties of the completion of the measure lambda. A family of sets R capital sub E is a ring. The measure lambda, which is defined on this ring, has the following property. It is invariant with respect to shift on any vector of the space E. It is complete, locally finite and sigma finite. It is not countable additive, and its continuation by Lebesgue Cartesian scheme vanish on arbitrary set of the space E. Let us briefly consider this statement. The invariantness with respect to shift following from the construction of this measure and from the approximation of measurable set by means of rectangles. And we define this measure as a completion of the measure which is defined on ring R small. Therefore, this measure is complete. Why it is locally finite and sigma finite? Any point of space E has the vicinity above sufficiently small radius, which has the finite measure. Therefore, it is locally finite, and since space E is separable, then it can be covered by the countable collection of ball of sufficiently small radius. Therefore, this measure is sigma finite. It is not countable additive since the whole space can be considered by the countable collection of a measurable set with zero measure, but the space contains some set with non-zero measure. Therefore, the countable additivity is impossible. And the same reason is the same reason gives the last statement. Now we have the measure with the following properties, and we can construct the space of square integrable of quadratically integrable function on this space, which is measurable with respect to the ring capital. Let S of R capital be a space of finite linear combination over the field of complex numbers of indicator functions of sets from the ring. Then we can introduce the non-negative Hermitian susquilinear form for arbitrary function from this space of simple function. We can introduce this susquilinear form by the following way. This form is degenerate, and we call function f and g from this space of simple function equivalent if the following equality hold. So the linear space of classes of equivalence of this function forms the pre-Hilbert space. And after the completion of this pre-Hilbert space, we obtain the Hilbert space of square integrable function. This Hilbert space is not separable, and it is sufficiently easy to present continuum orthonormal system of vectors in this space. And now let us consider the representation of group of shifts in Hilbert space of square integrable function. The space E as a group with respect to summation operation has the following representation as this space by the abelian unitary group of shifts. For any vector h, we consider the operator of shifts on the vector h, which act by the following way. It is obvious that this operator is unitary operator, and if we fix some vectors H from the space E, then we can define the one parameter unitary group in this space STH. The theorem 2.1 states the following: let E be an orthonormal basis in the space E, and H is a vector from the space E. Then the one parameter unitary group STH is continuous in the strong operator topology of the space B of H if and only if the coordinates of the vector H with respect to the orthonormal basis E belongs to the space L1. And now maybe we can analyze this statement and the sufficiently simple proof of this statement. Let us consider the following function, the indicator function of a rectangle, a unit rectangle with A is AK is equal to zero and BK equal to one. This is the rectangle in our space, and the indicator function of this rectangle is our function U. Discontinuity of the operator valued function STH is the will be the consequence of the discontinuity of the following scalar function and it is sufficiently easy to see that this function will be discontinuous if H is not belong to the space L1. The reason is the following. The value of this function is equal to the measure of intersection of the rectangle and the shift rectangle. And we can calculate this we can calculate the measure of this intersection and the measure of this intersection for sufficiently small t is equal to the following product minus t times hk. This is the length of the rectangle, which is the intersection of this. And this product of this product is equal to zero if vector H is not satisfied the following condition. This is the first part of this. This is the first part of this statement, and the second part based on the following: let H belongs to Elvan Jen, we can firstly we can prove the part about the strong continuity. Firstly, for indicator functions, and for indicator function, we can obtain the following estimate then. Sthy minus hpy the square of this norm has the following estimation. Constant, which depends on this rectangle by C and by HK in the norm L1. Then we obtain the continuity firstly for indicator function, and arbitrary function is the can be approximated by the sequence of linear combination of indicator function. Therefore, we obtain the statement about the strong continuity. And now let us continue our consideration. The corollary two states the following. Let E be an orthonormal basis in the space E, and if the group S, the group S, is equipped with a strong operator topology of the space B of H, then the topological group S with this topology is the unitary representation of the abelian topological group E in the space is a space H, but this representation is not continuous, as we see and in theorem one. Let us study what subgroup of the group E has the continuous representation. If E some if E is orthonormal basis in the space E, then we can introduce the subspace of this space, which depends on the basis E. L1 of E is the collection of vectors which Fourier coefficients with respect to the orthonormal basis E belongs to the space L1. This set of vectors L1 is the linear subspace of the space E, and therefore L1 of E is the subgroup of the group E. We can equip this subspace with the L1 norm. And therefore, we obtain the topological group, the abelian group L1, with the topology of L1 norm. Corollary 2-3 states that let E be an orthonormal basis in the space E, and if S1 of E is a collection of fifth operators on the vectors from the subspace L1, and if this set of operators equipped with the strong operator topology of the space B of H, then the mapping of the subspace L1 to the collection of operators S1 is the continuous unitary representation of the abelian topological group L1 in the space H. Now we study the following equation. We obtain the shift invariant measure on the space E, and thus this measure is unique. Can we decompose this measure on some invariant part? To the same, we construct some ergodic approach to this question, and we obtain the parameterization of measures satisfying the condition of shift invariantness, which is not decomposable to another measures. Firstly, I remember the following definitions. Let G be a group of mappings of the space E into itself. Let A be an invariant with respect to the group G algebra of subsets of the space E. A G invariant measure mu, which is defined on the algebra A, is counter-ergodic with respect to the group G if for every G invariant set A from the algebra A, either set A or its complement has zero measure. This is the ergodicity of measure with respect to action of a group. To our aim of description of collection of shift invariant measures, which is not decomposable on some more simple measure, we introduce the following extension of this notion, and the description of collection of fifth invariant measure, which is given in the term of ergodic decomposition. And now we extend the definition of ergodicity. Let G be a group of mapping of the space E into itself, and let R be an invariant with respect to the group G, ring of subset of the space E. Definition 2.4, a G invariant measure mu, which is defined on this ring, is called ring decomposable with respect to the group G if there are two G invariant subrings, R small 1 and R small 2, of ring R satisfying the conditions A and B, such that the measure of arbitrary set from the intersection of these rings is equal to zero. This G invariant measure is called ring ergodic with respect to the group G if for any two G invariant subrings, R1 and R2 of the ring R, the conditions A and B imply that there is a set A from the intersection of this ring, such that the measure mu has a positive value on this set. Here the condition A is the condition of non-triviality of restriction of measure mu on subrings R1 and R2, and the condition B is the following. The ring R is the completion with respect to the measure mu of the ring, which is generated by the union of ring R1 with ring R2. the decomposition of ring variant measure to the sum of ring ergodic mutually singular measures is called ring ergodic decomposition of ring variant measure mu. Now we obtain the ring ergodic decomposition of considered above shift invariant measure. An empty rectangle P from the set of measurable rectangles K sub E is called E equivalent to a rectangle Q from the same collection of rectangles if there is a vector H from the space E such that Q is the image of pi after the shift on vector H. A rectangle P, which is given by two vectors from the space L infinity, the point C of P is called the center of rectangle pi if coordinate C sub G is given by the following equality. Let the vector C belongs to L infinity and pi belongs to the collection T of E such that the center of this rectangle is zero. Then the rectangle Q, which is image of the centered rectangle P on the vector C, is non-empty rectangle if and only if the following condition is satisfied. Now I maybe consider the example of non-equivalent rectangle. For example, if we consider the rectangle P 0, 1, when any A equal to 0, any B equal to 1, and another rectangle P minus 1 half, any A equal minus 1/2, any B equal 1/2, and it is both unique rectangle, but it is not equivalent since the vector of shift is not belong to the space E. For every vector C from the space L infinity, the symbol K sub E of C denotes the collection of non-empty rectangles such that the center of rectangles deviated from the vector C on the vector from the space L2. Let C infinity be the set of vectors C from the space L infinity such that the collection of sets is not collection of this rectangle is not empty. According to this remark, the set C sub infinity is the following collection of vectors from the space L infinity. And now let us introduce the following factor space S infinity. The vectors from the space L infinity is equivalent to each other if the difference of these two vectors belongs to the space L2. Then we obtain the following ring ergodic decomposition of shifting variant measure. Let C1, C2 belongs to the set of equivalence class as infinity, and it is different element if the rectangle P prime belong to K of C1 and P2 prime belong to K of C2, then the measure of its intersection is equal to zero. Let a small of C be the ring of be the ring generated by the family of sets K of C for every C from the collection S infinity. Lemma 2.7 states that the function of a set lambda sub E, which is restricted to the collection of set K of C, is additive and has a unique additive extension to the measure lambda sub C, whose domain is the ring A sub C. Let A capital sub C be the completion of the ring A small sub C by this measure lambda sub C. Lemma 2.8 states that if C1 and C2 are different elements from the collection C infinity, S infinity, then the following statement take place. If a set A belongs to the ring as C1, intersect with A C2, then the measure of this set is equal to zero, as in lemma 2.6. Then we obtain the following result, the decomposition of space H into the orthogonal sum of subspaces. Let A be an orthonormal basis of the space E, then the space HE is equal to the has the following decomposition, has the following orthogonal decomposition, and any orthogonal component is the space L2, which is defined on which is defined by the measure lambda sub C with the domain A capital sub C. The ring A is the completion with respect to the measure lambda of rings, which is generated by the union of rings A sub C by all C from the set S infinity. The measures lambda sub C depends on the class of vectors C from the space from the set S infinity. The domain of this measure is the ring A sub C, and this ring depends on the vector C. Let us introduce the following extension new sub C, which is defined on the whole on the whole ring A capital. This measure nu coincides with the measure lambda sub C on the rings A sub C and is equal to zero on the if the that A is not belong to this ring and belong to the other ring. Then we obtain the following decomposition of measure for any vector C from the set S sub infinity, the measure nu sub C is invariant under the action of abelian group S. The S-invariant measure lambda admits the ring ergodic decomposition into the sum of mutually singular components nu sub C. And now we can consider the shift operators in the space H. Let vector H belong to the space E. Then we can consider the following unitary operator acting in the space by the following way. Theorem 3 states that the family of operators is one parameter unitary group. Any component of the above decomposition is invariant with respect to the group STH. The group of unitary operators is strongly continuous in the space H. If indeed it is, the coordinates of this vector belongs to the space L1. Then we should deal with the non-continuous the one parameter group, which is not continuous in the strong operator topology. To define the diffusion in the Hilbert space E, we should consider the random the Gaussian random vectors of the space E. Theorem 3.2, let mu sub d be a sigma additive Gaussian measure on the space E with trace classical variation operator d. Let E be the orthonormal basis of eigenvectors of this operator d. Then one parametric family of linear operators in the space H, which is acting by the following equality, is the semigroup of self-adjoint contraction in the space H. The averaging is considered, is defined by the following Pettis integral. And this one parametric family of operators is defined on is defined for every value of parameter t. If t equal to zero, then u d of t is equal to identity operator. And the self-adjointness is a consequence of boundedness of this operator and the symmetricity of vector of measure nu. The boundedness of this operator is the consequence of the boundedness of every operator S, and then we obtain the one parametric group of operators. Thus, this group is continuous. Now we obtain we consider the following general statement of the continuity of arbitrary semigroup of self-adjoint contraction. Theorem 3.3, that u of t be a one-parametric semigroup of self-adjoint contraction in a Hilbert space H. Then there are two subspaces, H0 and H1, such that these subspaces is invariant with respect to the group of u. This subspace gives the orthogonal decomposition of the whole space H, and the restriction of the group U on the subspaces has the following form. The subspace H0 is the subspace of discontinuity of this group, and this group is given by the following way. It is identity operator if t equals to zero, and it is zero operator is if the parameter t greater than zero. The restriction of this group on the second component of decomposition is a strong continuous semigroup in the invariant space H1. It is the continuous part of this group. And now we obtain the following. Let us introduce the analog of Sobolev spaces. The Sobolev spaces consists of all vectors on the space H such that its derivatives along the basis vectors that belongs to the space H, and the following condition of convergence of the derivatives satisfies theorem 3-4. Let nu d be a centered Gaussian measure on the space E with trace class covariation operator d. Let E be the eigen orthonormal basis of the operator d. Then the semigroup UD is strong continuous in the space H if and only if the square root of operator d is trace class operator. If square root of d is trace class operator, then the space Sobolev space W22 sub d is domain of the generator delta d of this C0 semigroup UD, and the action of the of this generator is the following. This is Laplace operator in the Hilbert space. Unfortunately, I want to finish my report, and I thank the participant for the attention. Thank you.
Thank you for a very nice talk. Well, any questions or comments? Possibly I have a question. In this theorem about decomposition in the case of self-adjoint contraction, why is it possible to do it without self-adjointness? If how much is it important?
Self-adjointness is sufficiently important. For example, the unitary operator for the discontinuous unitary operator, we have no such simple situation, and the collection of all unitary discontinuous groups can be described by the Hamel basis and it is very very difficult in the case when H is one dimensional complex space.
Okay, I see. I'm asking because I'm trying to relate it with some completely positive semigroups, because such a decomposition would be interesting. There are some finite dimensional Frobenius type theory for these semigroups, but infinite dimension, I think it is interesting it's far from be done. So
thank you. It is a very good question, and I hope that the analog of this statement for the complete positive mappings can be obtained.
Okay.
But it is a very interesting problem.
Okay, thank you. Any other questions or comments? Well, if not, then thanks, the speaker, again. Thank you.